Welcome back. Another Everdale video, number 2, the basics of Everdale. Yeah, it is something, you can say that. It is a whole lot different than Heyday. Heyday, you can work and participate on a derby and do stuff with each other, but it is not stop you for being fanatic with gameplay. So if you want to progress in Heyday, then you can do that without any problems, and also you don't have to wait for other members in Heyday to do something. That is totally different in Everdale. Everdale is about co-op. But not only co-op that you think I can do whatever I want. You can do that, but it will getting in the way for you will get some problems. For instance, if you play in the village, then you need to do research study. You have to research things first. That will cost time. And then after you finish that, you need to build it. Sometimes you get a free item, like it's a product. Then you will have the product and you can make it in the valley. For instance, this one. Let's bake Crumpy's berry pies at the valley bakery. If you start research, then you need 70 scrolls to finish it at once. Fast finish, but you can also use a villager to do this, and then after he's done, you can make the berry pie in the valley. So if you go to the valley, then you see the bakery. In the bakery, you can make the berry pie. It's now grayed out because I didn't research for it, so I cannot make it now. I can only make this because that is what I have. Opened, I played, I freed up, I researched. So all the things that you need to make or can make in the valley, you need to research before. So you need to research in the valley. There is one downside, that is the biggest problem in the co-op mode. If you open an new item in the valley and you do that with each other, and you open again and you open again, and some of the players are really busy opening everything and upgrade everything, and you cannot keep up with your village, then you will have problems. Because for instance, if you open the cotton fields, there's an area you can open the cotton you can play it free. You can first research for it, and then after that the cotton field you can research for it and then build it. And if you are able to get cotton, then Otto in your valley will ask for products you can't make. Probably it is something that can happen, and that is the problem. Is you, the villager, you are not keeping up, and if you don't keep up, you will get stuck with Otto, because you need to open up the trousers for making the trousers in the shop. So if in the valley the cotton is already done and you didn't research for the trousers, Otto can ask them in the shop. And if Otto is asking it in the shop, you cannot get it done, so you won't get the scrolls. And that is the biggest problem in the co-op mode. So the basics is you need each other to finish things together. So what can you do about it? What can you do about it? Now, it's a little bit difficult because, yeah, you need players that are working and playing much alike you. So if you have a certain amount of time to play Everdale in a week, then you need find other you need to find other players that play like the same rhythm, like also the same time. Sometimes it's a little bit more or less. That depends if you have a holiday or not, or if you're free, or that you go to the theater, or if you go to your friends' birthdays, whatever. But in the bottom line is that you can keep up with each other. And if you can keep up with each other, so with all the villagers, you can keep up at a certain level, then it is easy to go to the next step. For instance, there will be events in the valley. And an event is like this, sheep escape. And the first stage you need to do... this is the second stage. This is the first stage, I thought. But I am a little bit flabbergasted because I thought the first stage was not done yet. But maybe I didn't see that. I was thinking about it. But this is the second stage. So the first stage is done. The second stage is doing some install the sheep proof fence. So you need to make the things so the sheep cannot go away again. So they don't escape again. And then for certain tasks, you need a villager from the village. You need to send the villager to this, and you need to send him and do this task. But if you take the task, you lose him for 8 hours, so he cannot work in your village. And that is the thing what I'm trying to say here. If you are working together and you level up together to the study room 2 in the village, and to the study room, you need to get adjust with the buttons. So you need to have a study, but you need to stop on a certain way. So I am making study 4 complete, and I will do study 5, and then I will stop, so that every farm, village, every village player is at the same level, study level 5. So if everybody is study level 5, he or she can make the same things that you can, and then everybody is up and down, up and up at a certain stage, so they don't have to upgrade the clay stores, they don't have to upgrade the mine, they don't have to upgrade the stone mine runes. These things cost a lot of time, and if other players then already are in the valley researching things that need stone, then you cannot keep up with it. So the basics, again, the basics in the game is you need to find somebody that is the same level you are. Somehow you can compare it with how do you say that, derby maybe. It's for people, players, it's easier if they are level 100 than level 50. So if you want to have a very competitive derby, then you are looking for people that are probably higher level and can finish in 1 or 2 days. And they even want to spend diamonds. And that is the same in Everdale. You need others to finish things in Everdale. For now, I am just getting Everdale up and running for my villages. I have more villages, so I can play and jump over to the next one and to the next one. So I don't lose. So I don't have to wait. You need to wait sometimes. And that's okay. Sometimes you can't do anything. You need just time. So, for instance, I am in Orangeshire. And this is Bedrock Valley. You can see a level 5 XP, I think, badge. And I have some hearts. Reputation road is exceeding. I do have a construction token, plus 1. So everybody gets 3 construction tokens. If you want to construct things in your valley. And then I have 1 extra, so I can do 4 crates in the valley. You begin with 3 and you get 4, you get 5, you get 7, and maybe 9 as well. You can earn them on the reputation road. Every hour you get 1 extra. So if you use from the 3, you use 1, the counter will count towards 1 hour and then you will get 1 back. And then you have 3 again. So every hour you can earn a token. But the maximum tokens you can have is in the beginning 3. And later if you progress in the game with the reputation road, you can have 4 or 5 or 6 and more. But the tokens you don't use in the village, it's only in the valley. What you use in the village are scrolls. The scrolls you get from Otto, the scrolls are there. Use the scrolls to speed up research. And that is the thing you can do if you are almost done with something and you want to go with the last 10 of them or last 20. You need to get them. You need to save them. Because this is only the beginning. It will go so high. It is until level 15. And study level 15 is not the end. It will progress to 16, 17, 18, probably 20. There's so much to do. So much you can do in Everdale. But it's just beginning. It's not a week out yet in beta, so we need patience. We have all the time in the world. For instance, the whole winter in Holland, it will be pretty cold probably, so the whole winter we can play Everdale. And there will be times that you need to wait for lots of times. So now I need to direct the villagers. I need to give them a job. So you see, clay, red is not good. Red is fulfilled or it is done or they need something. So the red sign is not good. Green is okay. Blue is, yeah, they're on holiday probably. So Dean and Carolina are on holiday. Elijah is thinking, hello, I cannot have wood. And I cannot get wood in the stock anymore. And yeah, Jack and friends, the fixer, are waiting as well. Because my clay and my wood storage are full. You can see that at the top. So I need to spend them. What can I do? I can give them another job. Like if I want to make a figurine workshop, I need wood for that. So I can send him towards that. And it's okay, he can make figurines. I need to upgrade my chicken coop. And I will see what I need. Also, wood. I think it's a good idea to do the wood. Because if I upgrade this one, then I need to send a person, a villager to that. And I can send somebody that is asking for clay. Now there are 2 villagers busy with upgrading stuff. Making stuff and upgrading stuff. Making stuff, I need to do that because Otto is asking for it. So I can finish off the task. It will give me 53 coins. You will need them, the coins. And he's asking for 2 figurines. So, but I need 1 still on the wood storage. He needs to make wood with the evergrowth. Because now I have 2 players, 2 villages make need for wood and make something. But there's a red sign again. Why? They're hungry. There's no soup. So there is one person not doing anything. So I will place them all on the pumpkin patch so they can make some soup for their villages. Now the circle is done. Everybody is helping everybody. So there is no problem now to fulfill the jobs they do. So he can finish the chicken coop. He can finish the warehouse or the figurines. And he says, I can finish that in 2 hours and 12 minutes. Then you have 10 of them. And he is saying, ready in 1 hour and 47 minutes. That is the thing that is happening now. So I cannot do anything for that time. 2 hours, 12 minutes and 1 hour and 47. That's it. I need to wait. I can't do anything now. That's the downside of Everdale. You need sometimes to wait. And they are getting the pumpkins on the fields. They are making soup. So the first one is throwing the pumpkin in the pot, in the soup kitchen, and the next one will do that too. And it's really lovely that the pumpkins are growing. Look at her. She's walking around with a huge pumpkin. Amazing. But look at the... I will give him something, because I can fill this area a little bit. So what I want to show you something is the next thing that is so funny. Look at what happens if I speed it up a little bit. The nectar. I have nectar, so I can speed up the villagers, and I will give them a boost. Look at the pumpkins on the field. Isn't that funny? I think it's funny to see that. So it is they go from 1 to 1 to 1. There are 3 different pumpkin plots. So the first is on the field now. It's growing. The second is at a middle stage, and the last one, the highest one, is the biggest one. And She's cutting it down, and then she gets to the soup kitchen. It's the village kitchen, but it is so cool that they make that. The same if you look at this with the trees in the Evergrove. If you look at it, there are a couple of trees. They are growing, and she's cutting them down. This is the Evergrove, so an endless amount of wood is coming from it. But you see 3 trees. That is the biggest one. The middle one is a little next to the sign. And then the small one is on the left from the big tree in the Evergrove. So she's cutting it down now. That will be planted a new one. Look, it's coming. See? And then she will go to that one to give it water, and then she will cut down this one, the big one in the front. And try it right, and it's gone. And this stage, it's over and over again, and I really like this. It is really nice graphics, fun to see. So sometimes I'm just looking what they are doing in the turbo stage. That is just fun, looking at people at work. Isn't it? I think it's really fun. So, I can pause it and I can stop the turbo. So, be careful with this, because the nectar is really, really slow. It needs 4 hours to get one nectar, so it will give you 1 minute of turbo. For every day, if you go back to Everdale, then in the morning you will probably have 2 or 3 nectar. You can have a maximum of 5. So 5 times 4, 20 hours, and your stock is full. You need to get it from the machine. That's the same with the chicken coop. It will make 30 minutes 1 hour, 30 minutes 1 egg. And if you upgrade it, it will go from 3 to 6. So then in 3 hours you have 6 eggs. And the eggs you can use sometimes to do some kitchen stuff. So you can use the eggs to make extra soup, like that. Why? Sometimes it's okay to have a village, not 2 villages on the pumpkin fields. You can also send 1 to research items. Why would you do that? I will explain. This one needs upgrades as well, so you can also send 1 villager to this upgrade. You have 1 is making the wood, but now you have 3 things that makes wood, so I think it's not so okay to do. I think you will get behind, but I have already 39 of wood, so I don't foresee a problem if I do that. Why should I do the clay storage and not research? That is the big question. Maybe I need to research first, and then I can do the clay storage upgrade after I've done this one. But I have another one here, so I need to do 2. Then it's better to do it. Upgrade the clay storage. Okay, now I need a villager to do that. I will probably ask him to do it. And now there's something happening, and I hope you see what is happening. Look at the timer above this one. Look at the timer. There is something going on with that. Your efficiency is shown now. Why is that? It's an efficiency of 50%. There's one thing that I can use as an example to explain what is happening here. If you go to a store and you want some help in the store, then sometimes you need to wait because there are not enough people that work and can help everybody that visits the store. So if you visit a store where 8 people are working, then 8 people can help people who wants to buy something. So 8 people are busy. You are number 9 or 10 or 12, and you have to take a number sometimes, or you need to wait that somebody is available to help you. Then the efficiency is getting worse. The best thing is if there are 12 people helping visitors and somebody is ready and another comes in and can help immediately the person that is coming in, and the same over and over again. So there are more in the store, there are more employees available than customers come in. That is the perfect situation. So if a customer comes in and he sees 3 people are available, then your efficiency is 100%, because you can help every customer that comes in. But there is a problem. There are more customers than employees, because you cannot have 100 employees in your store. Because it will cost you too much money as a company. Okay, there are Apple stores and they have many people working in the Apple stores, But Apple asks too much for the appliances and for the devices, so they can have more support in the shops. But still, you need to wait. So when there are more visitors in your shop, but you don't have enough employees to help them, then your efficiency will go down. So you cannot help everybody when they are coming down. Sometimes they need to wait 10 minutes, 15 minutes, and then your efficiency will go down, go down, go down. And that is the same with the Everdeel. He can build the clay storage in 3 hours and 34 minutes without any problems, because there is enough wood, but there is not enough food. And I can show you what is happening next. If I say remove her, him from the chicken coop, and I will ask him to do the pumpkin patch to make food, you will see that the efficiency is gone and ready in 1 hour and 47 minutes. So efficiency of 50% will say that it will take two times longer to make the clay storage. Is that a problem? Depends. If you want to do it during daytime, then it can be a problem. But if you want to do it during the night, then it's no problem at all, because it makes no sense to be ready in 1 hour and 50 minutes when you are sleeping anyway. So it's better to get 2 items done than 1 in the night. This will take 3 hours and 49 minutes, but he will finish the chicken coop. And this will take 3 hours and 32 minutes. So it will finish. So you go to sleep, they work, your upgrade is ready from the clay storage, your upgrade is ready from the chicken coop, and your mine, the Evergrove, is still getting wood, so your wood storage will probably 40. That is the big thing, how the game works. So you can plan and do things. But there he comes. There is also a figurine maker. He is making figurines, and that will take also 3 hours and 15 minutes. But if you have 1 or you have 2, you will probably think, okay, maybe it's better if I send him to the clay storage, because then there is another clay storage done. The figurines you can make. I need only 2 now for the Otto. So if I have 2, then it's okay. He can stop for now. That's okay. Then you can say to him, okay, I do like it if you make figurines, but maybe I am more happy if you do an upgrade, because the upgrades are more important in the beginning than making products. You can make products if you don't need the villagers to make upgrades. Sometimes you need to wait and you can't do anything else, and then it's better to make the figurines in the workshop or use the windmill to make bread, a flour. So you need to think a little bit what you need to do for other stuff. So the basics, that are the basics, and it's now, and it will be the same in level probably 30. Only you get more villages and you will get more things to do in your Everdeel village. Okay, I need to wait for a moment. I will speed it up now, for... So he's busy with the figurine, so I can say, okay, now, come on, finish it. I use the booster now. The warehouse is full in 3 hours and 20 minutes. He's not talking about the efficiency. That is a little bit weird. He is about efficiency and he. There's two of about efficiency and they are not talking about efficiency. That's somehow weird, I think. But he is finishing the last one. And then I will go over to Freckles to show you what can... Where you can work for. So now he will get the item to the store. Look him walking. It's not a small figurine, it's a big one. Look at that. Bam. So his job is done. I can send him now to the clay start. And I want to upgrade it. Why can't I upgrade it? Would you like to get more coins from the shop? Oh boy, I don't have enough coins. I did not foresee that. Darn it. Just so I need to get some coins, but I will get some coins. Look at what the auto the trading will give me. 41 scrolls, 2 diamonds and 188. I have enough, I think. So now can I upgrade the storage? I will get him to it. Friends, the fixer is somebody that I don't normally have, but I pay 200 diamonds to get him for 2 days. I think it's the last day that I will do that because I'm gonna be really, yeah, slower now. Because I don't want him to fix things anymore. Because she is very, very expensive. So my efficiency is down the toilet now. 42, 48. In fact, it's not bad at all. So in 4 hours and 45 minutes maximum, there are almost there are 3 buildings ready. So this is perfect. It's running and it's okay. I do think the wood storage will be out of wood faster than... So maybe I need to change the guy. He works far 50% faster, the fixer. So maybe it's better him to get on the wood and better the lady getting this. See, now it's taking 4 hours and 31 minutes. I don't know why, but the wood storage is full in 5 hours and 6 minutes. Only that. 34%. How much time do I have him? 9 hours. Okay, so it's still okay. Okay, so I'm now jumping. This is done now. I don't want to do anything more because I need to wait now. So I'm going to jump over to a different... store, different village. So I need to close the screen because I need to log off the old way. I cannot log on the new way, so I don't want to show my email. So let's see how Freckles is doing. This is now Freckles. It's much bigger. I did some decorating. I know decorating will cost you diamonds, so it's just for the fun. Now I will stop with it. It's not working really great as well. So I can now speed up walking and stone masoning by 50% for 3 hours. These are the potions, and potions you can give the villagers to make them walk faster, do things faster, don't let them eat and whatever. But that will come in a later video. I only want to show you what is possible when you reach a certain level. I'm here 859. I have what, some reward from the chest, they're not so okay. I think the rewards are low. The shipping tokens and the consumption token, they are okay. I need them. So I have 2 pumpkin patch and already the beehives. Upgraded this one, warehouse to level 3, so I have more place for ingredients. And the funny side of this is that every product has his own stock, so it's not a total stock, so you don't have to cope with that. This is better. You don't need to think about certain things. You can also make better choices to get wool or wheat or making figurines or making this, making that. It's easier as if you have one stock. What will happen is that some things you will probably get more than other things, and then it's easier this way. I really like that. My money, village treasury, is leveled up, so I can now have 6,000 coins. Look at that. I did not do anything for 8 hours. I have too many eggs, too many clay, so it's working for me. So I can get rid of them from the buildings, so they cannot do anything yet. What is this? And you can stop making food as well. So all the, and the sheep is also ready. Do I, can I get more wool? No, I have 56, so I cannot make more wool, but I can make socks. Not, why not? Oh, storage is full. Damn. Okay, can I make berry pie? I have 5. I can make more. This 10 is full. Wow. Make this one. So what is happening here now is that this valley is of this village, what I have, is getting too fast. I'm working too fast on this one. My other ones can't keep up. So now I need to cool down. It's just cool down. I need to stop playing. I need to see what I can do here. And I can only do certain things in the valley, like the boats. I can do this because nobody is affected by that. I can get the books for researchers in the valley. So that's okay. So no problem. Look at that. I have 21 figurines. Too many socks. Now I can make socks again. And not another socks. And maybe this one, because it will give me 60. A lot of books. And books we can use. So now you can see I don't have any tokens left. I can do 4, but at the top of the screen you see the time, 59 minutes, then I will get the next token. The boat will go in 14 hours, so there is some time to do, complete the boat, so no problem. If you need coins, then you will do the golden boat, because the golden boat will give you coins instead of books and hearts. In the beginning, you need also coins, but I have plenty, so I don't need them. So I will give them to the farms, the villages that need coins. So I will not do this. And yeah, the sheep pen, okay. I can help, but I like it to have, not to do everything, because there are others that wants to do this probably. So that is the co-op mode. If you are playing with more villagers, then you need to keep in contact with each other and ask them what they want. You cannot decide everything for yourself, because then it's not a co-op mode anymore. So you need to have open communication, and that makes it a lot nicer and funny. Yeah, I like the game. Really, I like the game a lot. I'm really happy that that Supercell came up with this. So, another lesson. So, keep playing, and if you have questions, or you need to ask something, or you want to know something, the biggest server that is from Supercell, the original, the official server, Discord, is of course a lot louder, and more people are there. But if you want to something smaller server and get help, then you can go to the server below. It's in the description of the video. Every video Everdale has the same description. It's the Everdale Discord server, the same name, but a little bit smaller, so more attention for everybody. So if you want to visit that, look at the description in the video. So thanks for watching again, and hope to see you next time. So bye bye.